Friends, even the memories of natural disasters that have happened in the recent past give us a fright. We have heard about disasters such as cloudburst and excessive flooding in Mumbai, earthquakes in Bhuj and Killari, and tsunami hitting the coast of India. Last year, we have learnt about natural disasters such as fires, earthquakes, forest fires and floods, as well as man-made disasters. From whatever you learned, can you classify disasters such as lightning strike and water scarcity? This year, we will understand more about disasters. Are these disasters related to us in any way? What should be our role during disasters? What do you think? A few of such disasters can be avoided. However, for other disasters, we need to take care. In this lesson, we will learn about how disasters are linked to us and what we can do during such disasters. Amongst the various natural disasters, the one that occurs more frequently is drought. Due to scarcity of water, the farm yield reduces, crops get affected. This causes food shortages. In turn, this leads to famine conditions. Famines are classified as either mild famine or acute famine. Though famine is caused mainly by factors such as shortage of rainfall, it can also be caused due to human factors. Certain activities carried on by humans can result in famine. In 2013, Maharashtra state faced a famine of acute nature and the entire state got affected by it. In the past too, there were famines and situations such as scarcity of fodder. However, to overcome such situations, Chhatrapati Shivaji Maharaj and Chhatrapati Shahu Maharaj implemented various plans that involved storage and supply of water. In Aurangabad, Malik Ambar constructed special canals for potable water. Those canals are in existence today too. Famine is caused by various factors. Changes in temperature, thunderstorms, cold air, fog, environmental changes, crop diseases that affect the crop yield, etc. All these factors lead to shortage of food grains. Many records of famine have been found in the past all over the world. However, the most acute famines have happened in India and China. In the recent times, we have seen a steep rise in population leading to high water demand. This has resulted in an imbalance and in turn leads to water shortage. Increasing population results in limitless use of water. You must have heard about the Green Revolution. Green Revolution was aimed at increasing the harvest and production of food grains. The Green Revolution was indeed successful in increasing the food output. However, the chemical fertilizers, germicides and insecticides that were used caused a negative impact on the environment. That has also led to reducing the fertility of soil. Let us understand the steps that needs to be taken to reduce the severity of famine and also let our families know about this. By knowing the amount of water consumption at home, we will be able to identify the exact amount of water supply required. Water used in the households for daily course can be reused to water the gardens. Industrial wastewater should be retreated and reused. Rainwater can also be harvested. Rainwater can be utilized to recharge the groundwater. All such measures should be implemented. By considering the area where you live in, you should plan on how maximum amount of groundwater can be recharged. Planting trees and preventing excessive cutting of trees is a very effective solution for the same. It is important to study climatic changes over time and accordingly select the right crops to be harvested in that area. This year, we experienced heavy rains from June to October. There were cloudbursts at a few places which caused torrential rains. Sometimes, water droplets from a rain cloud do not reach the ground in the form of rain. Instead, higher temperatures of the ground convert these droplets into water vapor, and the vapor is then taken back in the cloud. This results in an increase in the concentration of water vapor in that cloud, resulting in a rainfall of 100 millimeter per hour or more in a certain area. This is considered as a cloudburst. Cloudburst is one form of natural disaster. Here are the examples of cities and states which have experienced cloudburst in the past. 6th of August 2010 in Leh, Ladakh, 2013 Uttarakhand, 26th July 2005 in Mumbai, on 26th of September 2019 in Pune. Amongst these examples, the intensity of cloudburst in Uttarakhand was unusually high and it led to considerable loss of human lives. Flood is another example of a natural disaster. In India, many rivers experience floods during the rainy season. Sometimes the intensity of floods is very severe and it causes great destruction. In 1976, Government of India established National Flood Commission to manage the flood control. Through this commission, necessary steps are taken to control floods. An outline of the control of flooding is created right from a remote village up to the national level. Under this, several measures are taken to prevent severe flooding. Some of the measures include building small dams in hilly areas, creating man-made ponds or pazar talao, artificial straightening of river courses, afforestation, linking rivers, etc.